These are the top 5 selling games on the official Oculus Quest store in December 2022. Number 5, Blade & Sorcery Nomad. Blade & Sorcery Nomad is almost identical to its PC VR counterpart, Blade & Sorcery. This is an action-adventure game that is a physics-based combat simulator in a sandbox arena, although additional modes have been added, including a dungeon mode, and more updates continue to come. Blade & Sorcery continues to be one of the most popular games in the entire VR genre due to extreme exposure of YouTube videos that have multiple mods, even mods where you're holding things such as lightsabers while fighting. Blade & Sorcery is just tons of fun for anyone who plays it, although it is rated mature, 17 and up, due to blood and gore and intense violence. Even being that rating, it has almost 23,000 ratings on the Quest store. With about a 4.25 star review score, this game is well known and well liked by many, and it is even possible to get mods on the Quest 2, which allows a lot more game time and further gameplay. Blade & Sorcery currently costs $20 on the MetaQuest 2 and can give you unlimited hours of gameplay due to its style and nature. Number 4. NFL Pro Era. NFL Pro Era is actually the first fully licensed NFL VR simulation game. It actually lets you step into football, be the quarterback of your favorite NFL team. Although this is a recent addition to the Quest 2 store, it is showing up in the top 5 selling already. It must have a lot of football fans out there. It has nearly 2,000 ratings and a 4-star rating. It just released on September 15th, 2022, and has had a generally positive reaction from people who are football fans, and even some people who say they weren't looking for a football game but gave it a try. Although a bit of a more controversial release, there are multiple 1-star reviews along with tons of 5-star reviews. It may be good to look into more reviews before you decide if this game is for you, as you'd have to pay $30 for it on the Quest 2 store. Number 3. Bone Lab. One of the most highly anticipated games on the Quest 2 ever, Bone Lab is a follow-up game to Boneworks, which came out originally and only on PC VR. Bone Lab puts you in a whole other universe inside of virtual reality, trying to figure out where you came from, what happened to you, and why you are there, and it is all about its physics engine. Every weapon has its own physics. Every enemy has its own physics. A lot of people who have talked about enjoying this game play it for many, many hours and just throw people around, throw around objects, and have fun in this game. It does have a bit of a storyline that you can unlock and actually even helps continue from Boneworks if you followed that before. It is a mature rated game with over 12,000 ratings and about a 4.6 star score among all those ratings. Although if you take a closer look at the ratings, many of them are trying to tell some of the most random stories that I've ever seen in reviews and not necessarily reviewing the actual game. Because of their humorous style, a lot of them are getting many helpful ratings because of that. Bone Lab hasn't been out for long, coming out on September 9th of 2022, and it still goes for $40 on the Quest 2. I know a lot of you own it. What do you think? Is it worth $40? Number 2, The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners Chapter 2 Retribution. Another mature rated game. I feel like we're starting to see a theme here. The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners Chapter 2 has been a long anticipated game that people have been waiting to come to Quest after Chapter 1 was known as one of the best games on the Quest of all time. This game was only released on December 1st of 2022 and yet is already number 2 on the list of top selling games. It is going for $40 with a bit of a lower rating than the other games we've seen, about a 3.8 rating on here with over 1,700 ratings, that being dragged down by a fair amount of 1-star reviews, 16% of them, and then although the 5 stars take up 44%, even the 4 stars come in at 17%, bringing this rating down a little lower. Some of these first ratings were at launch when people were talking about having hardware issues, frame rate drops, and other graphical errors. Developers have been working hard to update and address some of these issues to fix them, but of course those first ratings can be crucial for when a game launches. Doesn't seem like it's slowing down too much if it's still number 2 when it only released this month at $40 right now if you want to get it. One honorable mention before we get to the number 1 release, Beat Saber is still showing up at number 6, almost made the list, and even though having been out for years, Beat Saber still is one of the most consistently top selling games on the Quest 2 with over 45,000 ratings, a nearly 4.6 score, and still $30, even as you have to also buy the DLC song packs in the game, unless of course you want to mod and bring in custom songs. Beat Saber is still one of the top games. Number 1, Among Us VR. Among Us VR was a recent addition to VR on November 10th. It also launched on the Quest 2 store and is the number one selling game right now. At only $10, price may also play a factor in there, but this is of course the VR version of the wildly popular worldwide sensation Among Us, but now fully built up from the ground for virtual reality. With a 4-star rating, this does have a few DLC options if you want hat packs in the game that will up that cost a little bit more, $4 for one and $6 respectively for the other. This game has sold massive amounts since its launch, but it does have a lower rating, and if you go look through the reviews, a lot of it is because it says it has too many kids in it. Now, they said this was a hard stop, 13 years and up, older only. It even has a birthday check at the beginning, but that hasn't stopped most people from still being able to get into this game and invade lobbies that other people may have been looking for, a more slightly mature crowd. That said, if you haven't been in this game, Among Us VR does do a great job of putting you in a tense situation inside the universe of Among Us from a first-person perspective. You're looking over your shoulder, trying to survive while getting your tasks done, having no idea when that imposter is going to come up and stab you in the back. Among Us VR is very fun if you can get the right crowd, but of course, finding friends or having enough friends to fill a lobby with is very important if you're trying to avoid those not-so-fun moments.
Do you know how to send friend requests?
Okay, we gotta
die.
Go fix this.
Maybe
we're eating dinner.
Tell us how old you are.
I don't remember, okay?
Okay, I'm gonna Let's give you an A's in this game. You are fine.
Let's go.
Someone's blessing me. Help.
What?
Wait, what?
So those are the top selling games this month, but what do you think? What games are you absolutely enjoying on the Quest 2 right now? What games are you recommending to your friends? Or if you're still hoping that there's a Quest 2 under your tree, what are the first games you're gonna play? I'd love to know in the comments and chat with you about it. I wanna say thank you for coming out and being here with us once again, and I will see you in another reality.